I will show the examples here itself. I thought that will be better, but it is not giving me good related content. So let us start from here. Relational query language. So as far as relational query language is going to be concerned, we are going to take up query languages, and query language, it is going to manipulate, or it is going to retrieve the data from a database. So this was the prime intention. Next one was it is going to support the foundations on logic. This was the key takeaway. And the third key takeaway was it is going to be much optimized. The third key takeaway was it is going to be much optimized. How are these former relational query languages implemented? So in general, formal relational query languages, they are going to be implemented with a language called as an SQL. When we are going to take up with a SQL language, we do have the relational algebraic content. So we have some operations involved in it, and we have some regular execution plans which are going to take up. After relational algebra, the second more component which is going to bring into the relational query content will be the relational calculus. So both relational algebra and both relational calculus, these two are going to be the foremost content which are going to be included in order to derive all set of operations. So we talked about this content. Now, when we are going to call here as an employee as a database, then we call here as E. E is going to call it as an aliases. And this aliases we call here as an instance. The aliases we are going to call here as an instance. So we take up a query which it is going to be applied, and it is more or less, instead of calling the entire table, we will give an aliases, and thereby we are going to call it up. So this, it is going to build up a input relation for a query which is totally fixed, and thereby it is going to be having a result orientations. So coming to the prelims, there are something what to be noted, or to make for a easier and better understanding. So for that, we are going to create a instances. So here I'm going to call it as reserves. Reserves is going to have a instance. Then I'm going to call here as S1. What is S1? S1 is going to call it as instance. Then I'm going to call it as S2. S2 is also called as an instance. So we just talked now, we are going to create a aliases to that. And after giving an aliases, we are going to bring up this data here. So we have the reserves followed by silers. So the same silers we need to use for a self relation. At that point of time, what we are going to do is we are going to bring an aliases, and thereby we are going to use the same table. So that is where the significance of instance is going to come into picture. Now, coming to the relational algebraic content. So relational algebraic content, we have multiple ways to show up these things. One, we are going to call it as a selection. And what is this selection doing it up? It is going to do up to make some set of rows. So in order to include, in order to retrieve some set of rows, we are going to bring up the selection operator. Next one, if we need to take up or if we delete an unwanted columns from the relation, then we are going to use a projection. So projection, it is going, selection, it is going to use the sigma, and projection, it is going to use the pi symbol. Okay, next one, we have the third way of representing the things in relational algebra, that was, we call it as a Cartesian product. So Cartesian product, it is going to have an advantage is that it is going to combine two relations. It is going to combine two relations. Next one, the other way of bringing the relational algebra will be the set difference. will be the set difference. That is, we need to make some a minus b. So for that, we use an operator called as a minus, or we use an except. So these two are the two SQL functions which are going to implement the set difference. So we call here as an a minus b. And later on, we are going to make a union operation which includes two elements into the from the two relations. So these are the basic operations what this relational algebra is going to satisfy. So when we are going to work with this relational algebra, we need to have some additional inputs. Those additional inputs will be, one, we are going to call it as an intersection. Two, we are going to call it as join. Three, we call it as division. Four, we are going to call it as a renaming. So these are the basic essential attributes which are going to be part of the relational algebra. Now, let us talk with the subsetting of an elements where we call here as a selection. So now you can see here S2 is going to be the instance. S2 is going to be the instance of the table called as a Siler. So now we are going to bring this sigma here. So we need to identify rating. So rating we are going to call here as an attribute. Greater than we are going to call it as a condition here. And then we are going to apply it. We are going to apply over the instance. So now we need to identify, that is called as a subset of row. We are going to have some subset of rows here. So in this row, we need to say that I want to retrieve the condition which is greater than 8. So obviously I can take up either 58 or I can take up either 28. So we will get the answer, that is, it is going to select the Siler ID 28, or it is going to select the Siler ID 58. So that is where this scenario is going to come into thing. So one we call it as ME, another we are going to call the example for the Rusty. Fine. So we talked that there is some condition which is going to meet up, or it is going to be called it as a relation, and relation is going to be shortly addressed with instance, is shortly addressed with the instance. So that is what we are going to promote it. So selection, what it is going to do, it is going to select the rows. So that was the key takeaway from this slide. And other than this condition greater than, we have an option with less than or equals to, not equals to, like that. These are the different symbols what we are going to use up in the part of a selection. Next one. When we are going to make a selection operation, it can be joined with column operation. It can be joined with the column operation. That is, it can be taken up with a pi, where pi we are going to call here as a projection. So the definition, you can see that the results of the relation can be input from another relational algebraic operation. What is the another relational algebraic operation? One, it is going to be sigma. The other one was, it is going to be called it as pi. So sigma, it is going to be called it as selection. And pi, it is going to be called as a projection. So now you can see the query here. I need the columns of one, only Siler name. Two, I need only the rating. So we need only either a student name or we need only the rating operation. So if such is the case, so first time we will have the Siler name, that is FP, and the other we are going to bring up the Rusty relation. So thereby we will get a rating of 9 and 10. So only these two items are going to be needed instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, now we will be getting only 1 and 2 columns only. So that is what we say, the projection, it is going to delete the columns, it is going to delete the columns and bring the necessary columns. So this was the advantage of why we are going to use up the projection. So that's what we are going to have, the name and followed by the rating. Fine. Now let us have a detailed description of what was this projection is going to do. So projection, it brings the columns, whatever the relation algebra expression is performing. So this was the key takeaway here. So projection, it is going to bring the columns, whatever the relational algebraic expression is going to bring, that operation only projection is going to bring up. Okay, that it is done. Now what is Siler? Siler is name of the database. What is S2? S2 is going to be called as an instance of database, or we are going to call this one as an aliases. So what is Pi? Pi is nothing but we are going to call it as projection. What Pi does, what projection does, it is going to select only the columns. It is going to select only the columns. So now the answer was, I should have S number and I should have rating. Only these two items has to be displayed. So that is the reason why we are going to bring up the projection operator at this point of time. Okay. So now we made this projection symbol pi. Then we are going to have whatever columns we need to put up. All the columns are, we are going to call them as an attributes. Those they are going to be linked into the projection link. So in general, the abstract way of giving the definition was, it is going to delete the attributes that are not into the project list. So I have silo, I have name, I have rating, and I have age. So now we are going to delete the SID and we are going to delete the age columns. So that was the key intention, what we are going to bring up. So at this point of time, student Siler name and rating, they are going to be in the columns called. And here we are going to call the attribute, that is only age. So that is what we are going to bring up in this projection. Okay. So we talked about projection, then we talked about selection. Next one, the third way of putting the things will be the union, will be the intersection, and it is going to be the set difference. So as a concise way of bringing up, when we are going to work with the union operator, then we have all the relations which are going to be part of both the instance S1 and S2. But when we are going to talk about an intersection, when we are going to talk about the intersection, then we are going to have the common elements between S1 and S2. There we are going to get 3 and 4. But when we are going to take up S1 minus S2, then we are going to bring up the elements which are going to be exclusively in the instance 1 and not in the things which are going to be in the instance 2. So that is how we are going to build up with the relational algebraic content, that we work with union, intersection and difference. So in general, union, intersection and sect difference, they are going to be part of the relations. The two we have applied it into the mathematics. But now we are going to bring these relational algebraic content into the DBMS. So that was the key takeaway or the advantages what we are going to bring up in this DBMS, the two when we are going to work with the SQL. So here you can see that S1 is going to be an instance of the database Siler, and S2 is another instance of the Siler database. So now you are going to have the instances if I can bring it up, it is 22, 31 and 58. This is all part of S1. And another one we are going to have 28, 31, 44 and 58. So if such is a way we are going to bring the things, so 28 and 31 silers, they are going to be in both the instances S1 and they are going to be in both the instances S2. So similarly, we have 58 also. Yeah, we are going to have 58 also. So 28, 31 and 58. So these three items are going to be common, and exclusively we are going to have 44. Now, if I am going to do this union operation, then we are going to get up the things as 22 as so we are going to have 22. So we have 28 here. So that's my mistake. So we have 22, 31, 58, followed by 28 and 44. So these items, they are going to be part of a union. So I will reiterate this example so that there won't be any confusion again. So next comes the word called as a difference operation. Next comes the word, we are going to call it as a difference operation. So when we are going to take up the difference operations, the thing should be only S1, right? The thing should be only S1. So we are going to have the set operations. So 31 is going to be in a common. So 31 and 31 is going to be common. 58 and 58 are going to be common. So 22 I can put at this point of time, and 28 I can put at this point of time, and similarly 42, 44 we can put in the S1. So S1 and S2. So S1, it is going to be the instance of silers. Either S1 and S2, they are going to be instance of silers. So when we are going to say S1 minus S2, now we should get the answer, it is only 22. We are not going to consider the intersection part. We are not going to take into the part which is common between S1 and S2. So we are going to get the difference. That is, we will get only the record for Dustin. We will get only the record for the Dustin relation. So that is what we call it as 22, Dustin, 7 and 45. Next one, the third way of representing the algebraic expression was towards the intersection. So now we are going to have the two instances. There are two instances, that is S1 and S2. So at this point of time, we can say that 22 is alone in S1 and 31, it is common in S1 and S2. Then we are going to have 58. 58 is also common both in S1 and S2. And then we are going to have 28. It is alone in 52 and it is not common. So 31, it is put in common area. 44, yeah, it is outside. And 58, it is common, the things. Now what we are going to bring up was, we are going to have an intersection operation. So we have to see that the two tuples, that is for SID and 30, SID 31 and sailor ID 58, they should be part of the intersection when it is going to be provoked as part of the linear algebraic operation. Next comes the other symbol, we call it as cross product. We call it as cross product, and the other name for a cross product we are going to call here as a Cartesian product. The other name for a cross product we are going to call here as a Cartesian product. So now we are going to take up S1 as a relation. In S1, we can say n is equals to 2. Then I can have another S1 here. So that is m equals to 3. So now the total cross product will be m into n. So we should have 6 tuples, and there will be some duplicates also. So when we are going to work with a cross product, we will have duplicates also. So we will relate 22 with 22, we will relate 31 with 58, we will relate 58 with 58. And similarly, we iterate this for the second time. So that is where we are going to get this as n cross m. So we will be getting the duplicates. So such is a word what we are going to call here as a cross product, or we are going to call here as a cross join. So total tuples n into m is equals to 6. So we get these 6 tuples. Then we are going to apply the cross product operator. So cross product operator, we are going to bring up this relation in form of a cross here. Next one. Why we need a join? So that was the prerequisite. That is, there are some pros in cross product. There are some pros in cross product. So what are the pros in cross join or cross join was, we have duplicates. We are going to have duplicates, or we are going to have the redundant values. So to eliminate the drawback, to eliminate the drawback of redundancy, we do work with a join operator. So that was the scenario why we are going to bring up the things. So how we are going to bring up join? So join, we take up cross product. That is what we represent it with cross. Then we are going to have selection. That is what we are going to give it with sigma. Then we are going to have project. Project, it is going to be given up with pi. So one, we are going to bring up with cross. Next, we are going to bring up with pi. Third, we are going to bring up with sigma. So that is how we are going to bring up the join operators in point of time. So the way of representing a join will be with a symbol in this model. So this is what we call it as a symbol for join. So we take up this join in this model. Fine. Now let us talk about the of course there are inner joins, and inner joins take up the conditional join, the natural join, and the self join, etc. Then we are going to have the outer joins, where outer join is going to bring up the left outer join, right outer join, and full outer join. So we will discuss case by case. Now let us start up with working with the condition join. So condition join is also called as a theta join. That was the first key takeaway what we need to understand here. So condition join, we are going to call here as a theta join. So that was the key takeaway. So what was the condition it is going to meet? So the condition was, I'm going to bring up that it is going to say that it should be less than some content. So R, we are going to call it as an instance. Yes, we are going to call it as an instance. Now we are going to see, we call here as a condition. And this condition, we are going to select the subset of rows. We are going to bring up the selection of subset of rows we are going to bring up, and thereby we are going to make the cross product. We are going to make the cross product. So we just talked now that we said that there is a join operation, and join operation needs one cross product, two selection, and three projection. We talked about it. So now if I want to take up the cross join operation, so we can take up a cross product, we can take up a selection, we can take up a projection. So if we are going to mingling the select operator, if we are going to mingling the project operator to the cross product, then only we are going to delete the redundant values. So how we are going to eliminate the redundancy values means, we can eliminate the redundancy values when we are going to merge selection when we are going to make the projection with the cross product, then only we are going to do it. So in order to do that, the first type of example we are going to call here as a cross product here. So at this cross product, what we can do is we go have this join symbol at this point of time. So you can say that S1 is an instance for the silers and R1 is going to be for the reserves. So we have a reserves and we have silers databases. Silers database, we are going to create an instance called as an S1. Reserves database, we are going to call here as a R1. And between that, we are going to put a condition. We are going to put a condition. The condition was there is should be less than, and that is two between two attributes. The two between two attributes. What are the two attributes? The two attributes SID, one in S1 and other in R1. The SID, it is going to be in one. It is in SID is to be in one siler. Two, it is going to be in reserves. So that is how we are going to bring up the condition join. Fine. The next one, what we need to talk up will be the equi-join. The next type of condition, what we are going to bring up will be the equi-join. So when we are going to say theta join, or we are going to call it as a condition join, we can have less than, greater than, greater than or equals to, less than or equals to, etc. But when we are going to call it as an equi-join, we will make a equality symbol. So only such is a condition what we are going to take up. And if we are going to bring this condition, then we call such type of joins as a equi-join here. So equi-join, it is going to be a special case of condition join where it contains some equalities. It is containing only the equalities. That is, we make a SID and SID should be both, SID should be both in siler S1 and both in reserves R1. Then only it is going to accept the conditions. So such is where we are going to bring up the word called as an equi-join. So the extensions was when we use this symbol, we call this one as a non-equi-join. So we equi-join and non-equi-join, they are vice versa, they are opposite here. So we can establish a join operation with less than, greater than, etc. We call them as a theta join. But when we are going to use an equal to condition, then we are going to call it as an equi-join. And